I made a film with my brother, just the two of us made this film. Much later on, when Muhammad Ali was about to fight his last fight, one with Larry Holmes. And that came to us in an odd way. A young black kid, his early 20s at most, living in Chicago, got a job selling life insurance. And being black and adventurous and ambitious, he thought one day, well, maybe I can sell Muhammad Ali a bunch of life insurance. So he knocks on Muhammad Ali's door. Muhammad Ali answers the door, and he ends up selling him a raft of life insurance. But he also happened to know around that time that Muhammad Ali was about to have his next big fight. And this kid, who knew nothing about film, thought, oh, well, I've got to get his permission to make a documentary film. He does that, and then he finds somebody to help him out, but it turns out that the guy wasn't really doing that good a job. And he heard about the work of my brother and myself, and he's the one that brought us to Muhammad Ali. And that's how we got to make that film. I had already known Muhammad Ali because when he was first fighting in Florida, the BBC sent me there to do some filming of him. Not a great deal of film, but enough so that you really got a feeling of him practicing, preparing for the fight. Many years went by, and then many more years went by after the film in Africa. But, you know, here's a man that must have met so many people. How he could possibly remember me, I don't know. But one day I was crossing the street of Broadway in New York, and I heard somebody shouting, "Hey, Al." And I looked, and there was this guy rolling down the window in this cab, sticking his head out and shouting for me. It was Muhammad Ali. So we remained friends.